So Keith, I'd like to ask you about the Sphinx Memorial here. It's a war memorial here, built by a soldier here in Ku-ring-gai National Park here in Sydney.
What I know about the soldier is actually he came back from the First World War to Lady Davidson Hospital, where the nurses actually explained to him that he needed to get as much fresh air as he could. So he came into the national park, and alone he chiseled out of the natural bedrock an exact copy of the Sphinx that he'd obviously seen in Egypt. The War Society, when he passed away, when this soldier passed away, took on the Sphinx as its emblem to be used for its war memorial. And then after the Second World War, the mast from HMS Adelaide was presented to be placed in front of the Sphinx. And at 12 o'clock midday, the mast itself aligns with the front face of the Sphinx and casts its shadow directly through the whole body. And when I actually got sick and was placed in Lady Davidson Hospital for rehabilitation myself, the curators of the museum explained to me that the soldier who I'd interpreted had been gassed in the trenches had not actually been gassed. He'd actually had tuberculosis, and he'd come back to Australia to be placed in the hospital. And his wife and family used to come weekends and visit the soldier, but they were never allowed to actually meet. They would only talk over a fence that he could only wave at his family and children and his wife. But after many years of recuperation, he actually got better and actually was allowed to go home and leave the hospital itself. Lady Davidson Hospital is a rehabilitation centre that was placed here many years ago. We'll stop there for a minute.
Okay, cool. Hang on.
When you're ready.
Go, yeah.
We're not quite sure who built the altar in front of the Sphinx and who placed the Egyptian hieroglyphs upon the altar. One of the images shows a man with his hands raised as if to give him thanks. And there's the wing globe on the front of the altar. The two pyramids that are placed on either side of the Sphinx seem to have been placed there at a later stage, and I'm not quite sure whether his friends or soldiers actually came and built them as mementos or marking spots for the sun. But this park is just a wonderful park. All you hear is the birds. If you were here on your own for days upon end just chiseling out, you would have literally been in harmony with nature, which was the whole essence of him getting better after going into the World War One and being in the trenches. To come back to a park like this and be in harmony with nature would have been all he could ask for.